I wonder when was the last time I didn't wear a hat. I think it was that one time I was playing with those avocados.
Dang. It's been a minute. I think I might need to change my style up.
What's good, PD peeps? Today, I'm going to show my beautiful PowerDirector students how to go back in time with the flashback effect using PowerDirector. If you're new to my channel and you want to learn how to use PowerDirector, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. A flashback effect takes you into the mind of the subject by transitioning from a time in the present to a time in the past and then back to the present again. It's a cool effect that's used a lot in films and TV.
Let's dream a little dream.
You're going to need three clips to pull off this effect. One of the subject in the present, one of them in the flashback, and then one of them coming back to the present. So as you can see, I have these three clips in the library, and I'm going to go ahead and drag the present clip down to track one. So I'm going to hold my cursor over it, hold down my left mouse, and drag it down to track one. Now, I want to move my playhead to a position where the flashback begins. So once I get the playhead to where I want, I'm going to do Control T to split that clip. Now, I want to duplicate this clip, and to do that, I'm going to left click on it. I'm going to do Control C to copy it. I'm going to click on track two, and then I'm going to do Control V to paste it. Now that I have these two clips like this, I'm able to transition into a time when it looks like he's flashing back. So I need to add some effects to make that flashback look to the clip that's on track two. So I'm going to go to the effects room. And then I'm going to go to the search window and I'm going to type ripple. And I'm going to drag the ripple effect to the clip on track two. Now I'm also going to add another effect on here called wave. So I'm going to type in wave and hit enter. And I'm going to drag the wave effect down to the same clip. And now we want to add a transition to make it move smoothly into these effects. Because if we don't add the transition, the effects will just start out of the blue and that's not what we want. We want it to look smooth. So we're going to go to the transition room. And we're going to go to general. And then we have the fade transition. We're going to hold our left mouse over that, drag it down to the clip on track two. And then for our purposes, we want the duration to be about a little over 2 seconds. It could be whatever duration you need it to be to make it look good to you. Next, you want to add the flashback footage to the next track. So you want to go up to the media room. And I have a clip here called pass. I'm going to left click, hold down my left mouse. And I'm going to drag this down to track three to where I want it to start. Now it doesn't fill out the screen, so I'm going to double click on it. I'm going to go to object settings. And I'm going to change the scale. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. So now we want to go ahead and add a transition. We're going to add another fade transition here. So we're going to go up to the transition room. We're going to go back to fade, hold down our left mouse, and drag it to the beginning of this clip. And we're going to change the transition duration again. And we're going to go ahead and trim this down a little bit. It's kind of long. So we're going to place our cursor at the end until we see these two arrows pointing in opposite directions. We'll hold on our left mouse and we'll drag it into the duration we want. Now we want the flashback to seem a little different. We want to separate it by changing the colors in it. So we're going to change it to black and white. So we're going to go up here to fix enhance. We're going to go to color adjustment. And we're going to bring our saturation all the way down to zero. And then we'll close that out. And now you can play this back and kind of see what it looks like for starters. Avocados. So now that we got them transitioning to the past, we want to go ahead and bring it back to the present. So we want to move our playhead to where we want the effect to begin again. We'll go ahead and do Control T to split our clip. We'll left click on this clip to select it. Then we'll go ahead and do Control C to copy the clip. And then we'll go ahead and left click on track 4. And we're going to go ahead and do Control V. Now, instead of adding the effects, all we really need to do is copy the effects off the first clip that we made and add them to this one. So we're going to left click on this clip here that had the effects on it. Then we'll right click it. We'll go to copy keyframe attributes. We'll left click on the clip that we just added, and we'll go ahead and right click that. And we'll do paste keyframe attributes. It'll tell us a warning message. We're going to go ahead and click on OK. And now we have the same effect added to this clip. Once again, we need to go ahead and add a transition. We're going to drag the fade transition down to this clip again. We'll go ahead and hit on the length, change the duration, and we're good there. And so the final piece is to add the present clip back. So we'll go back to the media room. We'll get the clip that we want, and we'll drag it down to the position in track 5 where we want it to start. We'll go back to the transition room. And we'll go ahead and add another fade to that. We'll go ahead and click on the duration. And all you need to do now is add your sound effects where you want them, and it's a wrap. Let's play this back and have a flashback.
I wonder when was the last time I didn't wear a hat. I think it was that one time I was playing with those avocados.
Deja vu. If you like what you see, I'll leave some links to my PowerDirector in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.